Their brief was to keep the vultures at bay. Fogel himself led the other two uniforms, Willis and Saslow, to the house. Sarah Fisher came to the door, the FLO, who had been discreetly informed of the impending arrest, just behind her. Sarah's eyes opened wide in surprise at the extent of the police presence which confronted her. "Has something else happened?" she asked. "Have you arrested someone?"
"Is Melanie's father with you, Mrs. Fisher?" asked Fogel.
Yes. He's been ever so good. Well, he idolised that girl, you see."
Sarah Fisher paused. She looked as if she had begun to put two and two together and didn't like at all the sum achieved. Fogel had no time to waste. Once he had ascertained that Terry Cook was inside, he didn't intend to wait to be asked into the house.
"Move out of the way, Mrs. Fisher, please," he commanded, at the same time pushing his way past the woman, closely followed by the rest of his team.
Fogel guessed that Cook would be in the sitting room. He was right. Melanie's father was sprawled across the sofa in front of the TV. He had a bottle of beer in one hand, and a pile of sandwiches were on a plate on a small side table. Well, he'd certainly got his feet under his ex's table, thought Fogel, remembering Willis's description of the chaotic squalor of the man's own home. Cook looked pretty relaxed and content under the circumstances, until he swung round to face the door and found himself confronted by four police officers. Alarm spread across his sallow features.
"What's going on?" he asked, and then, echoing his wife, "Have you got any more news?"
Fogel strode swiftly forward until he was standing directly in front of the man.
"Terence James Cook, I'm arresting you on suspicion of the murder of your daughter, Melanie Ann Cook," he began.